My name is Maggie Murphy, and I am a postdoctoral scholar in Dr. Annalia Loria's laboratory here at the University of Kentucky. I actually began my career as a dietitian, but when I was in the hospital setting, while I enjoy talking with people and encouraging them to adopt heart-healthy diets, I really wanted to understand the molecular mechanisms. Why are people getting sick? Yes, we know we can treat through food, but we could actually make a more individualized therapy if we better understood the factors driving these diseases. So right now I'm studying obesity and metabolic syndrome. So kind of emphasizing in childhood with early life adversity, it's a very wide range from childhood neglect to even parent bereavement, early parental loss, or even divorce. And I grew up in a household where my parents divorced early, and it was very emotionally traumatic for all three of us. I have two older brothers, and I took a lot of comfort in palatable, high-fat foods. I ended up quite overweight. My mom took me to see a dietitian when I was in the fifth grade, and I just wasn't quite ready to lose weight at that point. But it was a couple of years later when my brother and my father challenged me to go running with them. As a result, we ended up doing a 10K as a family event every summer, the one that's run here downtown on the 4th of July. As I was going through this metamorphosis, becoming more knowledgeable about how the food we eat, the type of physical activity we perform, how that can really affect our health, I'm able to take some of the life experiences I have and put that into my research. So when I joined the laboratory last year, Annalia had started a pilot project in mice that are first exposed to the maternal separation or the first hit early in life to mimic chronic behavioral stress. We challenge these mice with a high-fat diet, and then we measure their metabolic outcomes in adulthood. And it's very interesting because we've been studying both males and females, and we find that even though both genders gain a significant amount of weight, it's more exaggerated in the females. And interestingly, which also coincides with what we see epidemiologically or in humans, so if we actually want to target and provide individualized medicine, which is the direction of the future, we need to understand what's going on between males and females. What makes a female more susceptible to weight gain? What inside the brain and the adipose tissue is driving this response? So that's what I'm trying to tease apart. Is the adipose tissue the main contributor, the liver, or is it the hormones that regulate appetite within the brain? We have some exciting preliminary data indicating that it's a combination of all of the above. So I grew up here in Lexington. I don't really come from a family of scientists, primarily accountants, except for my grandmother. I'm named after her, and she was the first female medical technologist in Western Kentucky. So when I finished my PhD, also here at University of Kentucky, I was happy to dedicate it to her because she really wanted to become a physician, but due to the times, so it's very important, and I very much appreciate that I'm here in a laboratory primarily of women to see the advancements women have had in science. My boss is very real with me. We have a very great relationship, and I think it does help that she's female and she largely understands what I'm going through, and we're able to be there. You know, it's much more than employee-employer type of relationship, and I want people to keep that in mind when they enter science, that this team is, and not only do we work together in the laboratory, but we also go out and do fun things together, and we try to practice what we preach, eating nutritiously. We all grow vegetables, and Diane, our research analyst, actually has a very large farm in Winchester, and she's brought fresh grown kale, t- tomatoes, squash. Analia's brought in zucchini. I don't really have a green thumb, so all I can really contribute are herbs. But I really enjoy that not only are we co-workers, but we're also friends.